This is the doctrine of what are called the forest books, the Upanishads. Sitting close in to a teacher who teaches you close in doctrine, and it is, you are it. Tattvam asi. The yogi says, Shivoham, I am Shiva, I'm it, I'm that power, and you are. People are caught in samsara, in the vortex of birth, death, sorrow, and so forth. We are to renounce those actions in life which engage us in this vortex, move into the forest, disengage ourselves, engage in meditation, and achieve the rapture condition of nirvanic harmony. There was an early form of Buddhism where this escape from life was taken seriously. The Buddhism of the doctrine of the ancients. It's also known as the Hinayana Buddhism, the little ferry boat Buddhism. Because in order to follow this Buddhism, you must give up the world and step into the little monk ferry boat that will carry you to the yonder shore. During the first century AD, that's say 500 years after the Buddhist time, a new order of Buddhism comes into form in northwest India. It is the Buddhism known as the Mahayana, the big or great ferry boat Buddhism. Now, to explain the difference between the two, I'm going to use a little anecdote that my friend of long ago, Heinrich Zimmer, once proposed. The Bay Area, with San Francisco on this side, and over there across the bay, Berkeley, with all the wise men there. So you're fed up with San Francisco. You're absolutely in disgust of life. And you've heard about Berkeley. You've heard about Nirvana. And you've heard what a peaceful, wonderful place it is, and what spiritual life there is over there. So you go down to the shore and you keep look day after day over at Berkeley. This is the desire for the experience, you know, of Nirvana. One fine day, a ferry boat sets out from the yonder shore, comes right to your feet. And in the ferry boat, there is a man who says, anyone for Berkeley? And you say, I. And he says, get aboard. But there's a consideration. Namely, this is a one-way trip. Now the texts say, unless you are as eager for nirvanic bliss as a man whose hair is on fire would be for a pond into which to dive, don't start. It's too tough. So you get in the boat, and the boat starts out, and you have a pang. You think mother or something like that. But it's too late now, and you're out in the water. And now it's ship ahoy. The splash of the waves on the hull of the boat. You thought it was going to be a short trip. It may take six incarnations. You're now a monk. And it's such a real relief and pleasure counting the beads in this hand and then over here, putting little flowers on altars and so forth. Life has been reduced to such simplicities that there's nothing, no problems at all. The last thing you want now is to get ashore on the other shore where something else might happen. One fine incarnation or another, the boat scrapes ashore. this is that moment of rapture, you know. But you can't live in that. We're there. So you got to show us a new life, a new breeze, and all that sort of thing. And then you think, well, I wonder how San Francisco looks from here. Now we're going to move into the other kind of Buddhism. This has been Hinayana Buddhism. Only those willing to give up everything, monks and nuns and so forth, and to play the little game of rosaries and flowers, they can get onto this trip. I wonder what San Francisco looks like from here. Forgetting that you're in the realm beyond pairs of opposites. Turn around, there's no San Francisco. There's no bay between. There's no ferry boat. There's no Buddha. This is it. This is known as the Mahayana. We're all there. And who's there? Well, the first doctrine of Buddhism is Anatman. All things are without a self. So who's on the boat anyhow? Didn't you realize that? We are all simply illusions of a consciousness that is the real ground. This is the illusion that comes with the rippling waters of a pond. Broken images that come and go. We identified ourselves with one of those that comes and goes. That was when we were in San Francisco. Now we have identified ourselves with the Buddha consciousness, which informs all things, and we're at peace. We can open our eyes and return to the world. We're in San Francisco. Do you see what we get? So this is known as the Buddhism of the Great Delight, Mahasukha. All is sorrowful and in perfect rapture.